Good morning student, myself Pankaj Kumar and welcome to my class. In last video we are discussing about internal memory where we had seen RAM and ROM. Today we are going to see or discuss about external memory. So what is this external memory? An external memory is the storage space that is available outside the CPU, or in other words we can say the storage space which we can use from outside the CPU. Okay. It is also known as auxiliary memory, or secondary storage. This external memory is also known as secondary memory, auxiliary memory, or secondary storage. Here we can store data, document, or other file permanently for future use. So this can store large amount of data for future for permanently. Okay, unless we delete the data, that will be there for permanently. Clear? And the data we can use in our future. Understood? Now, types of external memory. First, hard disk, compact disk, or examples of external memory, digital versatile disk, thumb drive. This thumb drive is also called pen drive, SD card and micro SD card. Floppy disk, then we have, this is the latest storage capacity. Where we can store the data online. Okay, and this is what, this is cloud storage, and the example of cloud storage, Google Drive, Dropbox, OneDrive. Now we are going to discuss one by one. First let me discuss about hard disk, and in hard disk we are going to discuss internal hard disk. Now this internal hard disk is exceptional case, and this is fixed inside the CPU box. Clear? In CPU box we can find out RAM, ROM and this internal hard disk. Okay, so this is exceptional case, and this is most important storage device because it can store large amount of data for future use, or large amount of data for permanently. Clear? So hard disk is the most important external memory device of the computer system. It is more reliable than other secondary storage devices and available with computer system. As I told you, it is fixed inside the CPU box. The capacity of hard disk that start with 500 GB in market. Nowadays you can find out 1 TB, 2 TB like that. Okay. Hard disk was introduced by IBM. IBM stand for International Business Machine. So it was introduced by IBM in 1956. Okay. And hard disk is fixed inside the CPU box, as I already told you. So this is about internal hard disk. Now we have external hard disk. As you can see the picture, this is the external hard disk, and this we can connect with the CPU using this USB cable, and USB stand for universal serial bus. Okay, it is a portable external storage device. Now why it is written here portable? Because this external storage device, that means this external hard disk, we can carry anywhere. We can keep in our packet, in our bag, and we can carry anywhere, and we can use there. Clear? So it can be used to store data, document, file, picture for permanently, and it can store large amount of data. Clear? It can be accessed anytime. It is connected to the computer system with a single high-speed cable, usually with plug and play interfaces such as USB, universal serial bus. So this is the cable which we have to use for connecting this external hard disk with CPU. Okay, understood? This is called plug and play. Plug and play, simply plug this one and use. Okay, now compact disk, in short we used to say CD stand for compact disk. It is one of the most popular secondary storage devices, but nowadays we are not using this. Okay, when we go 5 to 6 years back, that time it was very important. That one, it was very popular. Okay, it is used for recording, storing, playing audio, video, or text or other information in digital form. It can hold up to 80 minutes of audio, video. Here you can see it can hold up to 80 minutes of audio video, and the capacity of this CD is 700 MB. clear, 700 MB. Now it may be classified as follow: CD/R, this is compact disc recordable. In this type of CD we can record but we cannot delete, okay. But in second type, CD/rewritable, in this type of CD we can delete the content from the CD and store again. That's why it is written here rewritable. We can rewrite, okay, we can delete the data and we can rewrite again, clear. Then we have digital versatile disk, DVD. DVD stand for digital versatile disk. This is just similar to the CD when we talk about physical bias, but the capacity wise there is a difference. It can store the data up to 4.7 GB, but if you talk about CD can store up to 700 MB, okay. So it is a silver color disk with a diameter of 4.75 inch. A DVD has a capacity to store much more data than CD, okay, and it also needs CD DVD drive to run, and the CD DVD drive fix inside the CPU box, okay. Now thumb drive is also called pen drive. A thumb drive is a rewritable storage device. Now why it is written here rewritable? Because in pen drive we can store the data, we can delete the data, and again we can store the data, okay. So deleting and storing anytime possible, understood? That's why it is rewritable storage device that can hold data without power supply. It fits any USB port on computer, so we have to use computer USB port for connecting this pen drive, okay. It also called pen drive and flash drive. Pen drive and flash drive. Thumb drive is also called pen drive and flash drive. The storage capacity of pen drive varies from 1 GB to 128 GB. 1 GB, 16 GB, 32 GB, 64 GB, 128 GB, okay, like that you can find out in market. And this is so popular nowadays. Because most of the person are using this pen drive, because in cheaper price person are getting higher capacity storage device, clear. Then we have SD card and micro SD card. SD card we are using in camera and micro SD card we are using in mobile phone, clear. The SD card is an ultra small flash memory, a non-volatile memory card designed to provide high capacity memory in a small size. In a small size we are getting large capacity, high capacity, okay. And this is non-volatile, that means when we store the data, that data will be there unless we delete the data, clear. Now after success of SD card, mini SD memory card came into existence to meet the demand of mobile phone. As I already told you, this SD card, micro SD card, we are using in mobile phone. So after SD card, this micro SD card came to meet the demand of the mobile phone, okay, for the mobile phone. The capacity of these cards varies from 1 GB to 64 GB. Even nowadays we have 128 GB, 32 GB, 16 GB, like that, okay. So this is all about SD card and micro SD card. Then we have floppy disk. The floppy disk is a portable small storage device. The floppy disk were available in three different sizes: 8 inches, 5.25 inches, 3.5 inches. The storage capacity of floppy disk was up to 1.44 MB, okay. But nowadays we are not using this floppy disk. Why? Because the storage capacity of this floppy disk was 1.44 MB, and that was very less. That's why nowadays we are not using floppy disk. Instead of this, nowadays we are using pen drive, SD card and all. Now we have latest storage system, and this is cloud storage. Now what is this cloud storage? Cloud storage means the data is stored on remote server using the internet. Using internet we can store our data in server, okay. We can store document, picture, etc. from our computer and smartphone in the cloud storage. And Google Drive, Dropbox and OneDrive are the sum of commonly storage device. And you might have seen in your mobile phone this Google Drive, Dropbox and OneDrive. There we can store the data using internet, okay? And we can access anywhere, only we need to know ID and password, okay? So children, today we have discussed about external memory. I hope each and everything is clear to you. Thank you.